it's Brandi. So you might be wondering why I have this bright pink headband and like this ridiculously large earrings. Although, actually, believe it or not, I kind of like this look. Maybe we should like bring this back to to now. So if you're wondering why I look like this, as I mentioned previous with my movie review, I am going to be reviewing a classic timeless 80s rom-com. Now, when I say rom-com, I mean romantic comedy. So whenever I say rom-com, I just mean romantic comedy. Guys, hold tight. I don't want to lose you. If you have a girlfriend or a wife or a lady that you have a crush on or like, you should watch this movie review because then you will know a great classic romance movie that you and your girl can watch. And she will be so impressed that like, wow, you know this movie and you know what it's about. And she'll just be really impressed. And ladies, if you want to have a girls' night where you just, you know, are in your pajamas and eating your popcorn and your chocolate chip cookie dough, Ben and Jerry ice cream, you should also watch this movie because it's just, I don't want to give it away, but it is a classic 80s movie. All right, this is a 1986 movie and it is called Pretty in Pink. Family friendly. It is PG-13, so it is definitely family friendly with like teenagers. I know some teenagers that love this movie. They watch it and it is a classic movie that they enjoy watching. Okay, so summary. Pretty much it is a girl that is on the other side of the tracks, as they would say in the movie, goes to this high school and has has a crush on this guy that she calls a Richie, meaning he has money and she doesn't really have that much money. She and her father don't have a lot of money and her mom left when she was quite young. So the whole movie is pretty much her name is Andy, going through high school with a love triangle in a sense, the one guy that she likes that's a Richie, but then she has a best friend that also has been in love with her for a long time. So the pretty much the whole movie is focused on her and her life and her romance and her going through high school with like everyday life. All right, so actors, phenomenal A-list top actors. Molly Ringwald, she is Andy. She was in 16 Candles and also The Breakfast Club. John Cryer, he was Alan in 2 1/2 Men. Andrew McCarthy, he was in St. Elmo's Fire, great classic movie if you've not seen. James Spader, and one of my favorite movies, or not movies, apologize, shows called The Blacklist. If you've not seen that show, you should definitely check it out. Okay, the plot. So for the plot, they did a great job with setting up the character development. They talked about Andy and her background with her and her dad and her mom leaving. And then talking about, as I mentioned before, the Richie, Andrew McCarthy, who is Blaine, the guy that she has a crush on. They did a good job setting up his character and his friends and just the high school, you know, and high school and the drama of high school and, you know, the hardships of high school. Then the confrontation with the plot, they did a great job talking about the love triangle that Andy is in. So Molly Ringwald, who is Andy, she, as I mentioned, likes this guy that's a different background than her. And then Ducky, her best friend, John Cryer, he is pretty much in the same boat as her background. And then she works at the Tracks, it's called, and it is a vinyl record store, which I don't know about y'all, but I have my own vinyl record and I absolutely love it. So if you don't have one, I would definitely recommend like checking one out. I have, I think like maybe almost 20 different vinyls now that I love. Anyway, so she works at the Tracks and has a really good friend that is an interesting character. So that's kind of all like the confrontation. And then the resolution with the ending of the movie, very interesting to note. I listened to an interview about the movie and I'm not going to give away which guy she chooses, either her best friend or her crush, Blaine or Ducky. But originally in the movie, she was going to choose one of the guys and then they decided to actually rewrite the whole ending. And the guy that she chose had like a total haircut, like really short, because he was making another movie. So they brought him back, put a wig on him. You can definitely tell it's not his hair. And then she chose the other guy that originally they weren't gonna have her choose. So I thought that was kind of interesting to note. So when, not if, when you watch the ending of the movie, notice his haircut, because he has a wig on. So it looks totally different. Okay, so entertainment factor, definitely 80s movie, you know, classic, lots of great music. Talked about Madonna, you know, great 80s music. The outfits with the makeup and the hair, and obviously I tried my best to look 80s, but they did a phenomenal job with just the look of the 80s. It had that entertainment factor of the romance. It was more of a romance, in my opinion, than like a comedy. There were some funny parts, but definitely more focused on the romance between Andy and Blaine and Ducky. But great entertaining romance movie. Okay, I really wanted to mention about the screenplay. So a famous director, producer, and screenplay, John Hughes. I wrote down a list of all of his movies. He is a classic 80s and 90s, as I mentioned, producer, director, and screenplay of these movies. If you've not seen them, you have to definitely check them out. He was all three Home Alone. So Home Alone 1, 2, and 3. Dennis the Menace, great classic comedy. Uncle Buck, another really good one. Ferris Bueller's Day Off, 16 Candles, The National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation with Chevy Chase, and the European one. Phenomenal, great movie with the Christmas lights. If you've seen like tons of Christmas lights all over like houses and whatnot, that is the Chevy Chase movies, great movies. Breakfast Club, Mr. Mom, She's Having a Baby, and Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. So definitely check those out if you've not already. Okay, last but not least, the it factor. Did this movie have the it factor? Yes, yes, yes is my answer. It was very entertaining. It just was a classic John Hughes movie. Like, if you know the name John Hughes, you should know Pretty in Pink, along with, you know, other romance ones, but you should definitely know Pretty in Pink. It just was entertaining. I mean, it was an 80s movie. So if you like 80s movies, 80s music, you would definitely love this romance movie. All right, so rating. I'm gonna rate this movie a 9.2 out of 10. For the rating, you know, it just, like I said, was a classic movie. Great entertaining, great actors. I'm sure you know the actors. You just, they look younger, of course. You know, it's in 1986, so they look younger. You will definitely recognize these actors, and just very entertaining movie. So again, gentlemen, if you want a movie that you can impress your lady and watch and she be so impressed that you know this movie, you should definitely check this movie out. Ladies, if you just want a romance, girls' night in, Ben and Jerry, pajama, PJ night, you should definitely check this movie out. I definitely recommend that you watch it. Until then, you should keep watching those movies, eat that popcorn, maybe, you know, throw in some Ben and Jerry ice cream, chocolate chip cookie dough, which is my favorite. But until then, I will see y'all on Tuesday at 7 p.m. See ya!